So you've already ended the investigation. In fact, today you will be releasing to the report to the plenary. What was the whole basis of the investigation, considering he was not present and he did not cooperate?
Okay, we started this with the committee meeting, and then we come up with the motu proprio jurisdiction, no, to investigate the non-compliance of our colleagues in the House na expired na yung kanyang travel order, and then pinapabalik na dito sa House, but then he insisted to have such, and then based from the declaration of our speaker, yung justification na takot siya umuwi has been already answered by our speaker na i-protect naman siya in the House of Representatives. So with that, hindi naman natin pwede pabayaan itong violations na to, because otherwise babalikan din yung ating institution. So that's the basis, and of course we really wanted na yung mga colleagues natin is always present in the session in the Congress and working here in the Philippines.
Okay. Now, Congressman, the travel order has expired. So how many days has Congressman Teves technically been absent in Congress?
So the travel order ended in last March 9. So until this time, of course, he did not appeared in Congress and even find himself present. So absent siya after March 9.
Okay. So that would have been maybe, would it be fair to say roughly a week?
Yes.
And would that be a basis to actually expel a sitting congressman?
If that is a continuing action of the colleagues, of course, so we have our House rules to deal with that. So I cannot speculate, but then of course the House of Representatives has no choice if he will no longer going back in the Philippines.
Okay, but the problem is after today, you go on a six-week recess.
Yes, of course, we will be returned back by May 7.
So technically speaking, you can only count the absence from March 9 until today.
The session is, our work in Congress is continuing, but of course the session has, the session in Congress has its break. But then as government officials or working in the government, we continue working, no, even though we have the session in Congress. We have committee meetings that falls also during our break in session in Congress. So okay. walang ano dyan, no? Walang sinasabi natin na nag-stop kami working.
But I think for the benefit of our audience, what is the basis for Congress to expel any congressman?
There are rules in Congress that, of course, a certain representative can be expelled. No? So especially kung mayroong mga criminal violations, and it was
but is it criminal violations or criminal convictions?
But of course, defying orders is also a basis of what you call that, expulsion in Congress. Especially on the behavior, no, the attitude of our Congress, our colleagues na hindi sumusunod, no, sa patakaran dito.
Has there ever been a precedent based on the history of Congress in the Philippines? On what basis has a congressman ever been expelled?
As far as I know, parang wala pa naman, no? Under the Ethics Committee.
But under the Ethics Committee. So wala tayong pagbabasihan pa?
Yes, of course, at this time, we cannot talk matters on that. But then once na mag-progress, so I cannot tell na walang magawa ang institution ng Congress on this effect.
Okay, I know you can't reveal the results of the committee report. What process will it undergo today before it reaches the plenary?
At this time, I am finishing the report to the Committee on Rules and then submit it, and it's up for the Committee on Rules to act on our reports. And if they are going to schedule that for plenary today, so it's up for the Committee on Rules.
Mm-mm. Okay, because what's quite interesting in the case of Congressman Teves is you have the widow of Governor Roel Degamo. She is filing a petition asking that Teves be expelled from Congress. Has this petition already been heard in the investigation you conducted, or is the petition a separate case altogether?
As of this time, so far, Karen, we have not received any document in the committee as of this time. So I have no idea on that matter.
Okay. But do you have recommendations already to penalize Teves in your committee report?
As what I have mentioned, I cannot tell you at this time until our report is accepted and being discussed in the plenary.
Has Congress ever sanctioned a congressman for violating rules?
Based from the records, no, of our COMSEC, and it is just only verbally discussed, there are, but then it so happened that some of them have voluntarily resigned, no? So like what happened sa isang colleagues natin kay Convertis that time, no? So hindi na nag-decide yung committee because alam naman niya na may mga recommendations din doon. So nag-resign din siya. So meaning on the level na marami rin ginagawa ang ating ethics committee, and some of those na bigyan din ng mga decision, but then patapos na rin minsan yung Congress, so that's why hindi na rin masyado na i-discuss.
Okay, what can happen to Congressman Teves if after Congress goes on recess, he still does not show up, he does not report back to work when you go back in session?
So it depends to the decision of the plenary or the members later on, or some time kung kailan nila schedule. And as what I have mentioned, I cannot talk that further until after our Congress will decide based on our recommendation. Yung recommendation namin, pwede naman nila bagunin yan.
Okay, because the House already gave Teves a 24-hour ultimatum. He did not comply. So ang tanong nito, if you did not comply to an ultimatum, what can the penalty be?
The ultimatum is our request, no, our directives to really appear on us, and then of course that is a continuing failure niya to heed. So that's why we need to do our decision on this based on the rules, no, of the House. So mga possible recommendations dyan, di ba? May mga reprimand, no? May censure, suspensions, no? So, and then of course, kasama rin doon ang mga expulsion. So, it depends later on to the decision of the members, or kung ano man yung kanilang take, as long as the committee really find it appropriate decisions and action based on the appreciation that we have discussed during the series of our committee meetings.
Okay, but does Congress already consider Arnie Tevez as a fugitive, because for the record, there is no warrant of arrest against him just yet. Is that correct?
So far, that is very far from that, though. We do not even talk on that thing, no. Ang pinag-usapan lang namin dito is the conduct of our co-members na may hindi na authorized yung kanyang pag-stay outside, so pinapauwi na siya para maging present siya sa ating session dito sa Congress.
Mm-mm. Okay. On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, sir. We'll be looking forward to the announcement today.
Yes, thank you very much, Ms. Karen, for this opportunity also na makapag-sabi tayo and of course present what happened and the committee is doing in the House of Representatives.
All right. Thank you so much, Congressman Felimon Espares,